I'm now on sea level, 3 levels below the stage, and we're going to give you an unusual treat, something you've never done, we've never done before on one of our live HD transmissions. If the Met stage is the dining room, the rehearsal rooms on sea level are the kitchens. It's down here and in other rehearsal rooms scattered around the opera house that we prepare our new productions and revivals for several weeks before they're ready for the main stage. Right now, The Barber of Seville is being rehearsed down that hall, and the dancers from Les Troyennes are practicing their choreography over there. And behind these doors, mezzo-soprano Joyce Di Donato is rehearsing Maria Stuarda about Mary, Queen of Scots, under the watchful eyes of director Sir David McVicar and conductor Maurizio Benigni. It's Joyce's first big aria in the opera, O Nube, as the queen awaits news about her fate. As you may know, Queen Mary didn't have a particularly happy ending. Let's go in. Sound wonderful.
Oh, absolutely, thank you.
Absolutely wonderful. Grab your breath. Take a breath.
Joyce, adrenaline.
Oh, hello. We've never actually met.
I know.
Hello, how are you? Doing? Nice to meet you. And now, Joyce, this is a historic moment at the Met since, come back here. Since this opera written in 1834 has never been performed on the stage of the Met before. Now, after hearing that incredible aria, one has to wonder why. What a thrilling experience it must be to be playing Mary, Queen of Scots. What's it like?
It's extraordinary. It's full of adrenaline. It's overwhelming. It's such an important opera, first of all, in the course of Bel Canto, but such an important story and historical figure. What we've been talking about in rehearsals, there's so many parallels still today of what's going on in the world. So to bring her to life and try and, you know, help humanity keep learning some of the things, it's an incredible privilege.
Well, David, this is the second of Donizetti's so-called Tudor Queen operas that you have directed at the Met, the first being Anna Bolena last season. Tell us about these operas.
They're very, very powerful. They're very good operas. Mm. They're much better than people think they are. The bel canto repertory, it's whenever you take these pieces absolutely seriously, when you cast them to the max, the operas love you back, and they reveal themselves to be like treasure chests of great music and great drama. I think very often that it's overlooked or it's somehow belittled by people who think it's just about the vocalism, but it's about vocalism at the service of great drama as well, and that's what we're trying to do.
And I don't know if we told our audiences that this is Sir David McVicar who's directing. I don't think we introduced you. Anyway, yes, he is. Joyce, what exactly was going on in the first act since we didn't have subtitles? What was Mary just singing about?
What's happened just here is she's been led out into the forest for fresh air and sunshine for the first time in years. And she's sort of reminiscing and is in this sort of wistful mood, and all of a sudden trumpets sound off stage, which is extraordinary because she's been alone and locked up for so long, and they're royal trumpets. And something is coming, and we think it's the Queen, Queen Elizabeth. This is extraordinary because I've been writing letters forever, and here she is all of a sudden out of the blue, and I'm petrified. And I'm also building up courage to face whatever. It might be my death warrant. Mm-hmm. We have no idea what it's going to be.
Well, David, since this is a rehearsal room setup, tell us about how the production is going to look on stage. We have some technical photos from the summer that we're going to show the audience.
It's when we did Anna Bolena, what we did was an approach which was historical accuracy to the nth degree. This time we've gone for something which is freer and more romantic, but still honors the period of history that these people lived in, which I think is important because we, you know, there's Mary Queen of Scots and Elizabeth I, they're such familiar historical figures. So I think they have to be located within that period. I don't understand the society that these women live in and are governing unless it is about the 16th century. But it's also an early 19th century Italian romantic treatment of history. And we haven't forgotten that either. There's certainly a very romantic sweep to the set designs by John McFarlane.
Well, Joyce, you had a major triumph as Mary in Houston earlier this year. Is this your new favorite role?
Oh, gosh. Well, you know, the favorite... Yes.
Yes.
Yes. No, the favorite role thing is always a difficult question, but honestly, this is probably the role that I feel most honored to sing. And I try to put that off to the side because I've got to get inside of her persona and make her real and really bring her to life in hopefully a very three-dimensional, very heart-filled way. But it's an incredible honor to sing her, not only in the history of the women who have sung her, Caballé and Sills and these extraordinary figures, but also just who she was and what she meant to the world.
Well, we're going to let you get back to rehearsal. Sorry for invading, but thank you very much. Get back to work.
Thanks, Debbie. Great to see you.
You too. Bye. Nice to meet you.